All right, hello and welcome everyone, ladies and gentlemen, to the second game of the Stoles League match between Team The Dark Side and Team UTK, which I believe stands for the University of Tennessee. I'm not 100% sure. All right, so in the right position of MLG Metalopolis, we have Karma representing TDS as the Purple Terran. And on the right-hand corner, did I say left over there? I don't remember. Anyways, we have Khristian representing Team UTK as the Orange Terran. And what did Rican just say? Why are you typing in spectator chat? They cannot see you! Alrighty. So apparently threats worked last game. Let's see if they hold true for this one. Okay, both players getting their barracks down. It is a mirror matchup, TBT. I'm tempted to ask questions to the chat, but of course, 3-minute delay doesn't work quite so well. Alright. Shush. Yeah, I'm very insistent on my graphic settings being not the lowest possible, because I hate how StarCraft looks at that point. So my game does lag a little bit when there's a lot of stuff on the screen, but I do it so that it doesn't look absolutely terrible all the time. So if you could bear with me, when someone builds a mothership, it won't happen in this game, obviously TBT, but if you could bear with me when the frame rate dies when there's a mothership on the field, you will get a much nicer looking StarCraft. Look at the dirt on that barracks. You wouldn't get that at low settings, okay? Okay? Alright, there's the expansion for Karma, and it looks like Khristian is going to go with a kind of a mech build or just a harassing, early harass here. He doesn't have the, there we go, he's going to get that tech lab. Alrighty. He's getting a factory, so I'm curious to see what he's going to do with it, because he's not doing the reactor and then switch with his racks to get Hellions. It's a little curious. Now he's getting a supply depot over here. It's just so he could have a little bit of vision over here to see if there is something going on. And he is actually doing the switch on the tech lab. So what's going to come out of that? Is it going to be a siege tank? He doesn't have the gas for it yet. Okay. I love you guys. I love you guys, honestly. I typed in on the stream chat, tell me something I can say 3 minutes into the future, and I got, you are sexy alarm, and you can't handle the truth. I'm not going to put enough enunciation behind that. I just thought it was cute. Alright, so we have a orbital command morphing on this command center before he moves it over to start mining minerals. And we have a bunker. That's a nice place for a bunker. That's going to hit everything around it on the low ground. Yeah. Speaking of stuff, Khristian has not scouted the interior of Karma's base yet. I guess it was a wall off by the time he got here. Meanwhile, it's kind of the same for Karma. Although he hasn't built a whole lot since. I don't know. There's a engineering bay going down for Khristian. Siege tech is on the way, and he is getting tanks with that. Okay. It's a little bit new. So they are TBT, but they're doing completely different things with it, so that's always entertaining. We've got a couple of refineries going down for Karma, and a factory of his own on the high ground. He's also got three racks already, and he's just getting his add-ons right now. More supply depots going everywhere for the, Khristian, just to get vision around his own base. And siege tanks on the high ground, that will deny any kind of ground attack, based attack that Karma could throw at him. So far, Karma has only built marines. He did just finish the add-ons on all of his barracks, so he is building more marines right now, but I'm thinking that he's going to start pumping out marauders and tanks in the future. He is getting that tech lab on the factory. There's a scan going down to, for Khristian to see what Karma has at this point in the game, and it looks like he's decided upon attaining that information that he's just going to go and attack. Karma could be in a lot of trouble from this. All he's got so far are marines. He could retreat to the high ground and just kill him from behind his wall. So he does have a couple defensive options. He's also got marines back here, which will be very handy in this upcoming attack, because Khristian's unaware of them, and they could come up behind and start doing some damage to the siege tanks while they're stuck in siege mode from the high ground, or before they can get into siege mode. Karma does have his first tank on the low ground. He does not have siege tech yet, and this army is slowly moving its way over to his base. Alright. Stim going down, and lots more marines for Karma. He also has a medevac. The medevac could be huge. Oh, very nice. Both players sieging their tanks at the same time. Karma's tank getting the first hit off on those marines. Oh, he's got to be careful, though. He did have some marines up here. Come on. Sit here. Do it. Kill that medevac. Oh, very nice. He's decided to do a drop. Karma scans it, and he does see the medevac leave, so I'm wondering if he's going to know that this drop is coming in the back of his base. I don't think he's not really reacting to it. He's just going to sit here and protect his front. But here's the medevac. It is going to drop right in the middle of the SCV line. Let's see how many workers he manages to get. 3, 4, 6, 7. Oh my, 8. And manages to escape with all of his marines. Ouch. Okay, so that might have hurt his economy just a little bit. Karma has got 740 minerals a minute, and Khristian's got 800. Okay, so maybe it's not too terrible. 36 to 32. He's actually a little bit ahead in the SCV count. It looks like they just might all be here. Yeah. And it looks like Khristian has abandoned his attack. He's moved his tanks away. So now Karma looks like he's going to be doing some pushing of his own. Alrighty, so Karma is sitting at the gold right now. He's building a starport. Or I should say, another starport. And he's still got a lot of SCVs on his natural. He should probably move some of those back here just for a little bit more even saturation of his money. Khristian's kind of letting his minerals pile up. He is building a lot of marines, nothing coming out of the starport right now. He did build some missile turrets along the sides just in case of a drop in his own base. He's playing very defensively. That's not bad. He's just being really prepared. There are two medevacs here with a bunch of marines, so I wonder if he's going to do a drop of his own. Karma building two engineering bays for those upgrades. Very nice, very nice. Have there been any upgrades for Khristian yet? No, he's just got plus one weapons. He's also getting combat shield and plus one armor right now. Okay, I'm just wondering when Karma is going to decide to move out. Looks like he's a little bit busy back at base, building more units, getting more tanks, getting one factory, two racks, and a command center. All right. Three racks, actually. Yep. He's also getting missile turrets of his own. Where are those situated? I'm not entirely sure. Okay, there we go. He does load up the medevacs with some marines, and now he's going to do a drop. Khristian is going to see this, and he needs to be careful because there are missile turrets in the base. Yep. He's got to move his medevacs away. Well, he does lose one stimming into the missile turret. Oh, but he's going to lose this one. Oh, snap. So these marines have no ride home. As he managed to kill a lot of workers for it. He has killed 11 workers, but he does lose his marines to the forces of Khristian. He's still a bit ahead on food, and meanwhile, speaking of drops, Khristian is doing a drop in the main of Karma. Very nice, very nice. Karma's units were on the outside of the base, so they do take a little bit of time to come back in. They are doing a little bit of damage to the structures here, but not enough to do much. 16 workers killed versus 11. Karma's still with 1,000 SCVs on this mineral patch, on this mineral line here. He does have his third built, and so does Khristian momentarily. Alright. Very nice play by Khristian, I gotta say. He's really smart with his drops. He manages to catch him off guard. He plays really defensively, so Karma has very few options for trying to get at this base. Further reinforcing that Rican is female. You viewers will love that in about 3 minutes. After this game, I'll tell you guys the running gag. Very nice. Using the medevac for vision so he can destroy the supply depot. OP. OP. And this, he's going to use this, very nice. He drops the marines right on top of the siege tank so that the siege tanks are killing each other with splash. Oh, snap. There we go. Picking up some marines so he can put them on the high ground and do some damage. It looks like Christian's forces are kind of out of the way. He is setting up his tanks way back here on the very edge of his range. Take a look at his range. It stops just before the siege tank. But here come the marines from Khristian. Karma does not have nearly enough medevacs to try and keep this army alive versus all these marines. Just a few more marines than he has. But the siege tanks do kind of make up for it. And he's still doing damage to the production facilities with the siege tanks and the medevacs that grant them vision. Now he's all very nice. He does target fire the siege tank to destroy it, but now he's pulling away. He's got far fewer marines than he started with. He just needs to get some reinforcements in here, and then he will defend this attack. Actually, Karma is going to instead pull back. Good stuff. Good stuff. Very nice. Christian's minerals are skyrocketing now. That was at 2400. As soon as the battle ended, he spent 500 bucks on something. Yeah, 6 racks. Okay. Very nice. He's building a wall of barracks here. That's awesome. Okay. It looks like, very nice. Oh, sick. That was nice. Karma came in to try and catch those marines stuck at the tower, but the medevacs just picked them up and flew off like it was nothing. Very fast reaction time from Khristian. Well played, sir. You want to join TDS? You're pretty cool. Alright. So, Karma is protecting his tanks. He's got all these marines here. He's got significantly more marines than Khristian right now. Christian's trying to keep his base safe from the siege. It's not working so hot, but oh, very nice. The Vikings are coming in to pick off the medevacs so that the marines do not have backup or... Oh, did he get the full one? Oh, snap. So Christian's still trying to play defensively, but unfortunately he's not able to protect his structures on the high ground from these tanks. Christian's tank just a little bit too far away. They're scanning each other to see what each other's armies are composed of. Karma may just push in here and win the game. Apparently you guys want to see the blood. There's all sorts of blood being spilled today. Take a look at the units killed. 94 for Karma. How many of those were Marines? Oh, these Marines stimming into their death! Just wants to see what's up. No worries. At least that was a very small portion of Marines. Didn't manage to do any damage with them. He just ran into the tanks. Did do a little bit of damage to this tank by virtue of splash from its fellow tanks. But yeah, Karma's army is constantly increasing in size. There's a drop here. Another drop from Christian. He's got these Vikings here, so he's going to destroy these medevacs. They cannot go home. They're going to focus down this command center. Oh, this orbital command is going to go down. He's landing the Vikings. That's almost never a good idea, but he needs to at this point. He does not have any of his other forces in position to deal with this. He drops the supply depots just so the Vikings can walk over them. And, yeah, they are going to be quickly outrun by these Marines that are stimmed and low health. They're still in the base, though. He needs to clear these out. I don't know if he's distracted elsewhere. He's going to fly these over, then land them again. Very nice. He does keep a couple of them in the air, just to see where they are. Oh, and he does get a little bit of a surround, a concave on these Marines, and destroys them all. Meanwhile, are they still playing chicken up here? Yep. There's the scan. Where's the scan from Karma? Does take out a tank. There is the scan from Karma. Alright. Here's a drop, another drop from Karma in the base. He's going to head over here. He's going to see all these racks. And he's going to make that one burn. Very nice. All sorts of stim marine action here. Takes out the medevacs first, but Karma's Marines take out the other Marines. And now he can just stim over. And, oh, he's going to do a lot of damage to this production. Takes out the tech lab on that one. Takes out the tech lab on that one. No add-ons for you, sir. Christian. But at this point, I think Karma's doing a little bit better. I've liked Christian's play so far because you could tell just by his play that he's a solid player. He's just a little bit behind on food right now, and he's caught up in his base. He's tried to break out. He did do a really successful drop in the main of Karma where he managed to destroy the command center, the orbital command, and several workers. But he did get picked off by Vikings there. That's okay. And this is a lot of racks. It's like, fine, if I can't have racks in my base, I'll have them outside my base, my natural. What do you think about that? Okay, this is a lot of Viking. He's just going to come over here and pick off the medevacs one by one. He does lose a Viking in the process, but... Oh, very nice. Now Christian is unseating his tanks. He's got to move back. He is losing this game of chicken on this highway out in the middle of nowhere, Metalopolis. Very nice, very nice. Meanwhile, in terms of upgrades, we've got +3, just about to finish, +3 weapons for Karma, and +2 armor for Christian. +1, +2 is his current... Yeah, his current configuration, I guess. Alright. Karma creeping up with his tanks. Oh, there's a couple of Vikings in this pack. He's trying to avoid losing his Vikings to these mass Marines, because they are definitely going to try and pick them up. But these... Oh, Karma's Marines actually really suffered there. That was a lot of death. Now, Karma's ground forces over here consist of 2 tanks. Yeah, that wasn't as great of a trade. Speaking of blood, there you go. All right, a little bit more siege tank on structure action here. Using his Vikings to get a little vision, but the, now they're just a little bit out of place. They can't see that factory anymore, so they can destroy it. yeah, more Marines and tanks coming out. We've got more Marines from Karma. Khristian is going all in on Marines right now. Yep. I imagine that these are building Marines too. Yes, they are. All right. And looks like Khristian is actually making his fourth base. So he's... Oh, he's actually making a fifth base too. Fantastic. Now, that is just by economy. That is going to put Karma behind. He's got all, like, 100 of his SCVs at the third right now. And no other bases in production. I think he's got tunnel vision at this point. Karma is... he needs to... remember that there's a macro game to play, and he needs to go play it for a little bit. Meanwhile, there's a drop coming around from Khristian. This could do a lot of damage to the third base, the only mining base that Karma has. This could get ugly. Yeah, this is going to get really, really ugly. Karma does not have anything to defend against this. Except SCVs. One SCV does get killed. And I think they might be repairing each other, or they're attacking one of their friends. Oh, very nice. He picks up his units and he drops them in a much better position. This is a definite choke. These Marines are just tearing through SCVs. Oh, this is deadly. This is deadly. Look at all these Marines that Karma has to pull up here just to defend against this attack. One Marine left. No Marines left. There we go. All right. Looks like Karma had a little bit of a drop here too. He may have destroyed that orbital while I wasn't looking. There is a lot going on right now. All sorts of SCVs getting shot down as they're transferred to the new base. And the rest just sit here and take it. Stims in just to make sure that they can't run away in time. No, they're all being destroyed. Meanwhile, Khristian throwing his units at Karma's forces that have been sitting here sieged. Now he's got to pull away. Please siege these, thank you. Very nice. So Khristian completely eliminates everything that was sitting here, but unfortunately there's there's more waiting for him. And yeah, so it looks like Karma takes out another base of Khristian's. And now he's going to go after the planetary fortress. This is not going to end as well for Karma because the PF will... two-shot three Marines at a time. Okay. So Khristian just lost a lot of Marines there. He's still going all in on these Marines, and this is his, this is one of his last bases. This is probably the most well-protected by virtue of that PF doing so much damage to bio-ground units that are now running in, charging in. Oh, very nice. He stands outside of range of the PF and manages to get a couple SCV kills. Now he needs to be careful because all those SCVs are just going to sit there and repair, and now he's got to run away. There we go. He stims. He's going to run into the back, and he's going to prevent them from mining. This one SCV going over here to mine. He needs to move his Marines up just a little bit more. Oh, and here come the Marines from Khristian. Hopefully Karma takes advantage of this and moves in his own forces. He is attacking this factory once again. Yeah, Khristian's caught between a rock and a hard place. He cannot mine from this base. So he needs to get rid of these Marines. But meanwhile, he knows he's got Karma on the doorstep. Karma's going to take advantage of this. He's going to move in. He's going to absolutely shred these Marines. And then the production... And there's a GG from Khristian.